Bottle walls can provide light and beauty in your home. They can be a really stunning feature. The idea of building from beer bottles or wine bottles is not a new idea. In the early part of the last century, a guy called Tom Kelly built an entire house out of beer bottles that he'd taken from the bars in the gold rush town of Rhyolite. And even Heineken got in on it. In the 1960s, Alfred Heineken saw the potential for a waste material, particularly in the majority world, being available as a building block for people's homes. So he redesigned the round Heineken bottle into a square bottle, which he called the WOBO, the World Bottle. And the idea was, you know, advanced, and then it was killed off by the PR department, who probably feared the association of the brand with poverty and waste. But it was taken up big time by Earthship designers in the 70s and on from there. And we took the idea in the Brittany Groundhouse of using blue and white bottles for a bathroom wall, and it's stunning. And what we're going to try and do here is show you how to do this.
So we're going to make bottle bricks. First thing we've got to do is get hold of some nice bottles. Green and brown and clear bottles are relatively easy to get hold of and get them anywhere. The real tip would be to get hold of some blue bottles, which are really beautiful. And the tips on that would be to look for sapphire gin and Tinant bottles. To make one bottle brick, you need two bottles. You take two bottles of the same size. You measure up the side of the bottle. You decide how thick the wall's going to be, and therefore how thick your bottle brick's going to be. You cut two bottles using a tile cutter. Then you take the two cup ends of the bottle and place them together and tape them with gaffer tape, and then you've got your bottle brick. The best tool we found for making bottle bricks, for cutting them, is actually a ceramic tile cutter. What you do is you rotate the bottle around the blade of the tile cutter, and then it just breaks away. You take the two parts, tape them together, bottle brick. Once you've actually made the bottle bricks, what you then need to do is just work out where they're going. It's good to design the wall beforehand so you know where the colours are going. So you start off with a base of old salvage bricks or breeze block. You puddle it with mortar. We used adobe in this case, a kind of mud mix. We were trying to use as little cement as possible. And then you lay your first course of bottles to your design. You fill in between the gaps, and then you lay your second course of mortar, and again, just keep building up. And what you want to keep doing is using a spirit level, not to level along the wall, but across it. This drawing just shows how you can use a board of insulation. You drill holes in and slide the bottle bricks in, and then you can plaster between the bricks to finish off in the same way that you would for the internal wall. And you would use a sponge to we used a sponge to get the final lime finish on this beautiful bottle wall.